Yeah, I guess so. The Biden White House admitting that Major League Baseball's decision to move their All-Star game out of Atlanta will hurt middle-class workers. This is all over a voted law, that constantly being mischaracterized by the press and the White House. If you read the law, there's nothing wrong with it. Best I can determine is you got to show an ID to be able to vote absentee or some such thing. Tons of states have that, including Biden's home state of Delaware. But the key point on this one is the MLB decision to walk away is going to cost Georgia economy $100 million. One sports league that's not willing to bow to political pressure is the PGA. I might have to start playing golf again. They are keeping the Masters tournament at Augusta. Thank you very much. And today, Republican Senator Marco Rubio asked whether MLB Commissioner Rob Manfred would give up his membership to the famed Georgia golf course, Augusta National. Okay, now that one had to really hurt. And just to drive it home even tougher, let's bring in Sandra Smith, co-anchor of America Reports on Fox News, and she is tough as nails. Okay, first of all, is Manfred going to give up his membership? After all, that golf club is in Georgia, which has all these hideous voter laws.
What do they have, 300 members? I mean, it takes a lifetime to earn a membership there. I don't think so. And I haven't seen that he's responded to Marco Rubio's letter, but wow, that letter really takes him on. So you're going to bow to the pressures of what really appears to be misinformation about this Georgia law, and you're going to move this entire game out of the state. The economic impact, you cannot ignore that. I mean, Larry, just for you, I went and dug up the numbers. The All-Star game in 2020 had an $89 million economic impact in Los Angeles. Cleveland, the year prior, $65 million. Go back to 2013 in New York, a $192 million impact. That's fans, that's players, that's restaurants, that's hotels. And the MLB commissioner, I don't know, did he read the law? If he didn't read the law, did he read the four Pinocchios that Washington Post put on this? And to your point about the misinformation, what really are they getting wrong about this? Appears the big one is ending the voting hours early. And Washington Post gave that four Pinocchios. I mean, this is clearly just false information that continues to spread.
Why don't they stop Major League Baseball in Atlanta? In other words, if it's woke, if it's consistently woke stuff, far-left progressive woke, encapsulating Major League Baseball.
I don't know what
else. By the way, where the majority of fans could care less or even will oppose it. Shouldn't they just ban baseball in Georgia?
I'll tell you what. Ari Fleischer had the best answer to this earlier. You know, he's a sports guy, but also former White House press secretary. Earlier, he says, you know how MLB could have handled this? Because you kind of do wonder, well, what are they supposed to do? You've got these corporations that are bowing to the pressure. You've got MLB facing the pressure. They could have stopped and said, you know what? There's people who like the changes to the Georgia law. There's people who don't like changes to the law. This is America. But baseball's about uniting Americans. We can come together and we can have a day. We can have an all-star game without politics. Larry, everywhere we go, including our bathroom, politics are involved.
Speaking of which, now we're getting to it. A fabulous Wall Street Journal op-ed piece today by a chap named Dave Seminara.
Love it.
I guess he's a former diplomat and a very clever guy. So he now moves. This is just perfect. Sandra's lead-in is even better than she thought. He says in this op-ed, moving to the bathroom, I encounter my progressive razors. No, not Gillette. I ditched those in 2019 after the company released a ludicrously woke and decrying toxic masculinity. But last month he talks about Harry's. I never heard of them.
Yeah.
They're spreading, woke people are saying is spreading homophobic and transphobic content. Then they go on to Pantene shampoo. I'm giving you open field running here, Sandra Smith. And then there's one that he backed.
Pantene.
Pantene? I don't.
It's in your
shampoo. Do you use Pantene?
I don't know. I haven't in years, but apparently he takes on that too because they released this commercial about the life of a young transgender girl and her lesbian mothers. Patagonia, this was an interesting,
yes.
I kind of went down a rabbit hole when you put this in front of me. You know, he says, this is one of my favorite pieces of clothing. Love to wear it. And put the woke companies up on the screen there. On the top of its website, they've got a tab for Act Now. to stop climate change, warning that extinction looms for more than 1 million species of plants and animals. Next to the homepage, like the main bar where you go to buy your $35 t-shirt or whatever it is, there's shop, and then next to it, the tab is activism. And you can just go down whatever hole you want when you open that up. But I mean, this is...
But there's one more.
It's in your bedroom, it's in your bathroom, it's all over your house.
First of all, right, getting dressed in the morning is now way too complicated for me. But I want to say this. This fella says, last summer, after I complained that my preferred coffee company had gone too far left, readers suggested that I buy from Black Rifle Company, Coffee Company. They support veterans, and the coffee is very good, one reader wrote me. He was right, and word is spreading. The company's revenue nearly doubled in 2020, a year when every other business seemed to be going woke.
It's a fantastic
piece. Is that what we have to do, is just fight back through our consumer power?
No, but I think
Or just make fun of the whole thing, which deserves to be ridiculed?
To go back to Marco Rubio's letter, and I think it's really an important one, because he's highlighting the hypocrisy of many of these companies that are appearing to be so woke, and they're bowing to these pressures. They're doing business with China. Right?
Right.
And in this letter, he says, wouldn't it be truly bold, addressing the MLB commissioner, if you would speak out on behalf of the voiceless who face arbitrary imprisonment, forced sterilization, coerced abortions, rape, and other horrific acts? Obviously, the human rights abuses that are happening in some of these countries, like China, that these very big corporations continue to do business with.
This is Tim Cook's problem at Apple. He's a good man, but he's made a big mistake on all this stuff. You're right. They'd write NBA, China. I mean, come on. What's woke is woke.
But you know,
I think they should ban baseball. New York Yankees.
I come from a baseball family. I love baseball.
I'm a Yankee fanatic.
Go Cubs.
And Atlanta is always difficult. So we could just take them off the map because they're not woke enough.
You know
but
what
then again, the Yankees aren't woke either. Trust me on that. Non-woke Yankees. Anyway, that's grist.
Can I just finish with this,
segment.
Though? I think this what was also really interesting about Marco Rubio's letter was, would the MLB commissioner who has a membership at Augusta, would he really do that? That takes personal sacrifice.
No, let's see.
That is company sacrifice. That's personal sacrifice.
Well, give him 24, 48 hours to see if he responds.
The azaleas are just too pretty.
Oh, Lord. You're right. Masters. good for golf. I might have to take golf up again. I'm a tennis player, but what
the
heck.
I can see that.
Thank you, Sandra.
Thank you,
Appreciate it very, very much.
Thank you.
Now